Hello guys, welcome to Global Finex financial reporting classes. So in this video, the first lecture, instead of covering about the syllabus and starting with our regular classes, first I would like to introduce the paper to you so that you can get an overall idea about what is financial reporting all about and how to approach the examination. What are the resources that you need to tackle the exam? What are the skill sets? What are the various aspects of the exam that you need to keep in your mind, right? So that it can help you in your preparation for financial reporting examination, okay? So first point is that your ACCA is structured in a level manner, in a level-wise manner. By level-wise manner, I mean that if you recall, you have a paper called as F3 Financial Accounting. So in financial accounting, you deal with journal entries, ledgers, trial balance, BRS, pre-P&L, balance sheet, your other comprehensive income, statement of cash flows, changes in equity. So basically, you will discuss about the fundamentals of accounting, journals and other stuff in your F3 paper, financial accounting paper. Then that knowledge will be used for F7 financial reporting, right? So here what we'll do is we will take the knowledge from financial accounting. Yes, in F3 also some standards like property, plant and equipment, intangible assets are already covered over there, but only at a basic level, at the ground level. The more advanced topics are covered in financial reporting. Okay, and there are few standards which are not discussed in financial reporting. They will be discussed in the next stage of your reporting, that is SBR, Strategic Business Reporting, previously called as Corporate Reporting in P2. Okay, now it is replaced with SBR, which stands for Strategic Business Reporting. Now, you are in this level, financial reporting level. So here, majority of the standards are discussed. Hardly 6 or 7 standards are separately discussed in strategic business reporting, right? And few standards like IFRS 9 financial instruments, IFRS 16 leases, these are discussed at a basic level, IFRS 15 as well, revenue recognition. These are discussed at a basic level in financial reporting, and these are discussed at more detail, more depth in your SBR level. Okay, so coming to this paper, financial reporting, your examination will be for 100 marks. This 100 marks examination requires you to score 50 marks for passing the examination. And please remember, if you aim for 50 marks, you will land up in 35 to 40. So I request all of you to aim for at least attempting the entire 100 marks of the paper and effectively writing at least 80 marks of the paper so that you can score 60 to 70 marks on an average. I'm talking about an average student. If you are a topper or if you want to score good marks in FR, then I would suggest that you appear for 100 marks effectively and efficiently so that you can score a global rank or an Indian rank or a national rank for that matter. It's absolutely possible. Right? There are cases where students have scored more than 95 marks out of 100 in financial reporting. So it's not a big deal as such, but yes, you need more practice and you need more involvement with the subject. Now, this 100 mark examination is split into 3 levels or 3 categories or 3 sections. So first section, section A and section B, these two sections deal with MCQ questions, multiple choice questions. Previously, they were multiple choice questions when it was paper-based exam. Now, when it is a computer-based exam, CBE, computer-based exam, so now we can't call it as MCQ questions because apart from multiple choice, you also have fill in the blanks, you have match the followings, you have choose the correct options out of these 4. Multiple answer questions are also there. So there are various questions. So I'll just say that these two are objective based questions. Okay. So section A has 15 objective questions, OQs, 15 objective questions, and each question will consist of 2 marks. So giving you a total of 30 marks. 15 objective questions into 2 marks. Section B has 3 scenarios. 3 scenarios. And from each scenario, they'll give you 5 objective questions. 3 scenarios into 5 objective questions into 2 marks each question. So 3 5 is 15, 15 2s are another 30 markers. And then you have section C, which is your theoretical question, essay based question. This is called as constructive response questions. Constructive response means your theoretical or essay questions. Here you will have 2 questions into 20 marks giving you 40 marks. So you can see 30 plus 30, 60 plus 40, 100 mark examination. So now these 2 are again, as I said, objective questions. Now let me tell you something. Your section C is a predictable area. And when I mean predictable area, that means that usually questions come only from 3 different areas of your syllabus. Usually section C questions come from 3 different areas. First one is consolidation, preparation of consolidated SOFP and P&L, statement of financial position, statement of profit and loss. Then second area is your single entity financial statements, that is preparation of single balance sheet and P&L, statement of financial position and statement of profit and loss. And the third case is usually interpretation. Students usually call this as ratio analysis. Right? So this is the section C usual area. And apart from this usually tested areas, very rarely questions can come out of cash flow statement as well. Preparation of cash flow statement, usually what they do is interpretation of cash flow statement they will give you. So that is covered under interpretation. Cash flow statement preparation under IAS 7 is very rarely tested for 20 mark section C question. But yes, there is a possibility for that, right? So this is the basic introduction about your FR examination. And now your exam, as you know, will be divided. Okay, let me just give you a summary here. So what is financial reporting all about? Provides you with the skills required to apply accounting standards, conceptual framework in the preparation of financial statements, and how to analyze and interpret those statements, as we discussed. Now, this is the framework that I have already told you. Conceptual framework will be there. This will be used for financial reporting, accounting the transactions, preparing single entity, preparing consolidated statement, analysis and interpretation of the financial statements. This is an overview about your entire syllabus. Now, if you see the tackling the examination, you can see that 15 objective type questions for 2 marks each. Then your objective type question cases will be there. 3 cases, 5 questions into 2 marks each. And then you have section C, 40 marks, which relates to one or more of the requirements. Okay, you can see that 36 minutes you have to give, always read the requirements. All these are basically your suggestions given for how to tackle this examination, right? Now, when we say computer-based examination, since your exam is computer-based examination, all your classes, we will be focusing on computer-based examinations only. That means instead of solving any question using the whiteboard, what I'll be doing is I'll solve all the questions using Excel so that you guys can have a better understanding about Excel functioning as well. So I would suggest the students that when they are preparing for their examination, don't take pen and paper and sit and solve it, because your examination will be computer-based. So your preparation also has to be computer based, right? Sir, how can we, access the CBE environment? How can we get knowledge about the CBE environment? See, I'll just show you a quick demo. ACCA FR CBE specimen. See, FR CBE specimen examination. I'll do one thing. I'll copy this and I'll paste it in your class notes so that you can directly access it. Okay, whatever. So you can see here, once you go to this link, you can see full specimen examination. Just click on that and it will load for you a specimen examination. Pearson View is the software which is provided for, which is guiding ACCA examinations as such. And you can see first they are explaining you 3-hour time period and all that stuff. Just click on the next. Then they will give you general instructions on where the explained answers and all. This won't be available in the exam. Flagging for review and instructions on navigating through the exam. All this stuff is there. Come on. Section A, Section B, Section C. Okay. Yes, please. Yes. Okay, now this is your examination screen. This look exactly like this in your real exam as well, right? So first question, you can see consolidated financial statements are presented on the basis that companies within the group are treated as if they are a single economic entity. So which two of the following are requirements of preparing the consolidated financial statements? All subsidiaries must adopt to the accounting policies of the parent in their individual financial statements. That is not required. Subsidiaries with activities which are substantially different to the activities of other members of the group should not be consolidated. That is also absolutely wrong. All entity financial statements within a group should be normally to be prepared for the same accounting year and prior to the consolidation. Yes, this is right. Unrealized profits must be eliminated. This is also right. See, I know you don't know the answer as such in the first lecture. So I'm just showing you how your answers will look. See, this is which two of the following are the requirements. That means you have to select two out of the four. Right? And you can see the rest of the screen here. Explained answer, this won't be there in your examination window, obviously. Since this is a specimen, they are explaining this. Calculator will be available if you forget your regular calculator. You are also having the freedom to carry your own calculator to the examination, no problem. Scientific calculators, approved scientific calculators, you can carry. Right? So you can see calculator, whether you want a scientific calculator, you can get that. If you want a standard calculator, you can get a standard calculator as well. So you can just change it and you can use it according to your convenience. Then you'll have a scratch pad. This is basically nothing but if you have any thoughts or if you have any ideas to jot down, you can just use it in any of these things and you can keep it like that. And this scratch pad won't be visible to the examiner. I don't know from where students are getting this information, but no, examiner will not have access to your scratch pads. They are personal. They are your own scratch pads. You can write whatever you want out there. Even if you leave also, it won't matter. It will be absolutely fine. Then comes flag for review. So this is very important. See, suppose I have seen the first question, I have answered it. Second question is asking me what is the current liability of the leases. I haven't prepared IFRS 16 leases, for example, or I am unable to recall in the examination regarding how to classify current and non-current aspect of the lease liabilities. So should I waste my time here? No. Just flag this for review. See, it is showing a red color flag now. Just go to the next question and go ahead. Right? At the end, when you are about to submit your exam, just click on this navigator icon, which is shown at the right side bottom. I think I'll just switch to full screen here. Now you can see at the right side bottom, you can see navigator option there. So just click on the navigator. It will show you all the questions which you have attempted. See, this is already completed. This is incomplete. You have left it for review. And these are all unseen. That means you have skipped reading this particular question. You can go to any question. Just I'll click on that question number. It will take me to that particular question. Right? So like this, I can access any question. And when I'm talking about section C, you can see that constructive response questions. Now you have an Excel sheet here, right? You can increase or decrease your question area length, and you can you only have this much area to work on the consolidated financial statements. This is something that I'm really worried about. I don't know why this part of the question is made mandatory to be visible. Rather than asking it here, they can actually put the requirements of the question below this and directly use this entire screen for Excel, which is actually being implemented as we speak. I hope it will be implemented for your examination at least. Okay? And please remember, your Excel usually will have so many options, goal seek, solver functions, the data tables, pivot tables, all that stuff. Your examination Excel is just an extract. You won't have access to all the information, right? So you will be able to use only these tools which are visible here. Bold, italic, underline, change the font color, highlighting the cell, center, left and the right alignments. You have decimal formats and percentages and fractions. That's all. You don't have anything else. Cut, copy, paste. That's all. You can't even right click and insert a cell or insert a row here. See, usually what we'll do, we'll right click and we'll say insert row, insert column. That is not there. You have to cut the data and paste it again. So please structure your answer before you start solving that question. Right? And then, okay. And then for commenting, like, you know, for your interpretation related questions where you have to calculate the ratios and other stuff, you will be given a Word document where you can type your entire data like this, right? Sure. So that is how your examination window will look like, and I have given you the link for your specimen examination in your first video itself, in the first notes itself. And then moving to your examination study support resources, just go to accaglobal.com, go to student section, study support resources. You'll be able to find various resources. See, ACCA qualification. I'll just copy paste this as well in your first lecture, first class notes itself, so that you can utilize these things. Oh, come on. Copy. Paste. Why is it not pasting? Okay, that's some technical error. I'll paste it later. Don't worry. Now you can see, just select your financial reporting and all your examination resources are available here. See, introduction to financial reporting, guidelines, examination team giving you some instructions, other support guides are there, retake guides for people who are appearing for the second time, syllabus, examinable documents, maths related stuff, English language support, then technical articles, specimen examination, past papers with answers. You can literally click on this and you can get both past papers, question papers and answers as well. See. Okay. So these are the various past papers and other resources. Now, for your examination point of view, you have 3 hours, right? So 3 hours implies 180 minutes. And you have to write 100 marks examination in 180 minutes, which gives you approximately, not even approximately, accurately only, you have 1.8 minutes per each mark. So if you have a 2-mark question, you can spend maximum 3.5 minutes on that. If you have an MCQ, spend not more than 3.5 minutes per objective type question. Maximum 3.5 minutes per each objective type question. And for section C questions, 20 marks into 1.8, which gives you 36 minutes per each MCQ, constructive response question or an essay question. Make sure that your essay question is completed in 30 minutes. Or else you can alter. See, some students are quicker in MCQ solving. Some students need less time for objective but need more time for essay questions. So determine according to your pace. This is just a general guideline or an instruction for you guys how to tackle your examination, right? And please make sure that your preparation includes all these resources. What are the key resources? Examiner's approach, comments of the previous exams, how previous students have written the exam, where did they make major mistakes, what are the frequently mistaken areas in the examination, and how to tackle your CBEs, guide on CBEs, how to approach, all these are fine. What I want you to make sure is that you are reading examiner's review, Then, okay, they are, that is not completely given. I'll write here. So, resources that you should be able to use are examiner's review, content, comments on the previous question papers, then past papers, technical articles from the ACCA website. You should have knowledge about your exam kit and practice kit. This is mandatory. At least one book you have to complete, either Kaplan or BPP. One exam kit, so you should mandatory complete. Completing both of them will give you more results. And examinable past technical articles. Mock exams, it is mandatory for you to write CBE based mock examinations before you enter into your exam hall. Don't become a superhero. This is not a a cricket match to go without practice. Even cricket match today, people are practicing before they go to the stadium, right? So make sure that you are giving your mock examinations before you go to the exam hall. Technical articles are very important for you to understand for your examination, right? So these are all the various resources which you should be using, right? Chill. So with that, I'll conclude our first introduction to financial reporting video lecture. In the next video, I'll discuss about how you can access your class notes, what are the points that you need to consider before you start your preparation, how to deal with Google Drive lectures, recorded lectures, how to stay motivated to watch the classes, all that points I'll be explaining in the next video, right? Till then, thank you guys. Thank you.